Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how you can get a US IP address from anywhere in the world. So basically people will need a US IP if they want to access American only websites, and there's surprisingly quite a few of those. For instance, most of the big TV and media sites are all restricted to US only access, and that's all based on your IP address. So if you connect to a website and you've got an American IP address, you'll get one result, and if you do it with a British or a German or anywhere else, you'll get another result. Let me just show you. Okay, so let's say we go to one of my favorite sites, Pandora, which is a sort of music, online music jukebox that's got a free plan at the beginning of it. It's wonderful. I've been using it for years, but as you can see, if you're not in the US, it won't work. It's got this message saying we're working on bringing our music service to other parts of the world. They've had that message for about 10 years. The font's changed, but the message hasn't. So it's quite difficult for some of these firms because of copyright and rights issues and stuff like that, really. Okay, but this is because I haven't got an American IP address. So let's get one. I'm going to show you one way, the way I use to get an American IP address, and then I'm going to show you a free way at the end that has some slight drawbacks but might be suitable for you. Okay, so let's just close this down, and I'm going to show you how I get an American IP address by using my favorite VPN program. Now, a VPN is a virtual private network, and what it does, it's basically a security product. It keeps all your information secure and keeps you anonymous online. There's no logs and lists of where you go, what you do, and everything. But it also has another added benefit that you can change your IP address at will. Now, as you can see here, we've got a big map of the world, and there are little dots, and all these are servers all over the world, VPN servers, which you can connect to. Now, I'm in Europe at the moment, so I've got a UK IP address, and basically all my UK sites work fine. But if I want to access something like Pandora, I need one of these, a US IP address. So let me just click on the US, and you can see NordVPN is connecting to the United States now. It takes a minute or so to make the connection. But as soon as it has, I will have an American IP address. Okay, so it's now connected. So every website I visit now, I will have an American IP address. Now, I should remember, this is quite important, that now the British websites that I normally use, like BBC iPlayer and ITV and stuff like that, they won't work when I've got an American IP address, so I need to disconnect when I'm doing that. But at the moment, I'm showing an American IP address. So let's start at Chrome, and let's go back to Pandora, say my favorite website, my favorite music website anyway. And can you see here now Pandora has checked my IP address, said, hey, he's in New York. He's okay, we'll let him in. And we can now go straight into Pandora, and it works perfectly. Let me just... Pandora's just playing as normal. It just goes into my free account, and it'll work perfectly. It's because I've got a US IP address. Okay. Now, I did say I was going to show you another option. NordVPN is not very much. In fact, if you get the longer deals, you can get it for about $2-3 a month. But obviously there is a cost involved. I think it's worth it because, you know, they've got to pay for the servers, support staff, bandwidth, and all stuff. People often ask, oh, we don't want to pay, I want a free one. Well, there is a free version, but it's kind of free. The biggest free version is called Hola. And it's totally free, and it's a decent enough VPN. You can get it on this page. It's hola.org. So you can go there and get it installed. Now, it will work, and it should work with Pandora. But before you use this, you should know that there is a cost. Nothing is ever free. Why would these guys supply anything completely free? Because it's not. It says gets Hola, it's free. What actually happens is that while you're connected to Hola, people get the can use your internet account. can use your internet connection rather. So they can use your IP address. Basically, they rent your IP address and connection out. They don't use all of it, a small proportion, and only when the CPU is idle. So you might argue it doesn't really matter. But they use it and then they rent it out to their premium members in a company called Luminati. So this is a proxy company. It's quite expensive, but people can use their network to hide their IP address, and they use it for all sorts of different things where you need multiple digital identities. Okay, but basically, Luminati uses the computers and connections of Hola. So that's how it works, really. If you're happy with that, it is free, and you won't have to pay for it. And if you're using if you've got a super fast connection, you don't mind people routing through, as a P2P connection would work. That's fine. It's free. I'm not going to use it ever, but I'm going to stick to NordVPN. So that's the end of my video. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I hope it's explained something and shown you some options. There's a link at the description which shows you the NordVPN's latest offers, so you can get the cheapest price at any point just by clicking on that link. Okay, thanks very much for watching. Goodbye.